What is up, boys and girls of YouTube? This is gonna be a quick video. Quick. So I'm gonna do A to Z God guides. All the gods, 99, about to be 100 gods, 5 minutes or less. Hit the sub button right now so you can power me to get through all of these. It's 100 of these. 100 of these that I am gonna do. We're gonna cover your items, your build, your abilities. Someone said actives, your abilities, your best matchups, worst matchups, and your play style. We're gonna start with Arthur. All, like I said, A to Z, we're gonna get through it. Let's get into it right now. Get your starter item. This is all jungling. Most of these builds will carry over to other things, but this could be jungling on these gods or just playing these gods in general. Overall, starter items will change if you want to play them in a different role. Builds probably gonna stay the same. So, well, that's a lie. If you're solo laning, you're going full tank. So, as a jungling Arthur, Assassin's Blessing, Mace 1, Blink Rune, or Beads. If they have a lot of CC, Beads. If not, Blink, because you want to be able to initiate, you want to kill people. Ninja Tabby, why attack speed? Because you want the faster energy gain. Crusher, why attack speed? You want the faster energy gain plus the power, pen, and passive. Jotuns, because CDR is actually insane on him, and I love it. Masamune makes you a little bit tanky, adds to the movement speed that you would like to have on the god because your movement is kind of strange, plus adds power. Magi's Cloak, because the god gets locked down super easy. This is going to stop you from being locked down in general. Titan's Bane, because you already know it's Titan's Bane. You need some pen to kill the fucking anybody late game. This will be the perfect build for you. Abilities, you're going to max your 1 first, ult 2nd, 3 third, 2 last. 2 does the least amount of damage. Your 1 has a sick combo off of the 2, which does your most damage. Your 3 has potential to do a lot of damage if you are hitting multiple targets. And your ultimate is a Naja ult that does insane damage and you can't beads out of it once you're up in the air, because you still take the damage even if you land. Boom, bang, there's the abilities, there's the items, there's the build. I'd say your best 3 matchups are going to be anything you can lock down and sit on. So you're going to go ahead and look at all the gods. Usually they're going to be the squishier targets like mages. So I'd say out of the mage pool, anything that can't run away. You've got Ra, you've got Zeus, you've got Hebo, you've got anything that can be knocked up and CC'd are going to be your best targets. Plus you are knock-up immune. So actually in a Hebo, you do great. Outside of that, out of your top god pool, you're really not all that awesome. You have very bad matchups into a lot of the junglers. Anything that locks you down will wreck you. Rat. Pele's a little bit different. Pele can't knock you up. So Rat, you've got Susano disrupt and just dumpstering on you because he can kite away from you. Naja will destroy you. Naja will super punish you. Any cripples, so Nox, super hard matchup. Something you want to watch out for. I know this is a little bit more than 3 or 4 matchups. I'm just trying to go through some matchups for you to look for, some matchups for you not to look for. Arthur's harder because he doesn't have a lot of solid matchups. Immobile gods that you can sit on, you can do well against. You want to snowball. Playstyle on Arthur. Early game, like very, very early game, you actually do a lot of poke damage if the other team doesn't have equal amounts of damage. So if you're going against somebody that has high poke, say a Thor or a Serket or a Naja or a Hebo, those things will outpoke you. But if you're going up against gods where you're just able to use your abilities over and over again, Nemesis, anything, Mercury, things with lower damage early, you'll be great. Your mid game is kind of your spike because you're able to one-shot people with your combo. Your ultimate does a lot of damage in the mid to late game. Your 1 does a lot of damage in the mid to late game, especially with damage items coming out like the build you have. And that's kind of what you're looking for. That is essentially what you want to do on Arthur. Late game, your playstyle can adapt. You can be more of an assassin playstyle, which is how I like to play him. Go in after an ability is used and fuck somebody up. Or you can just go ahead and wait it out and play like a frontliner because you do have a lot of CC in the kit and a lot of lockdown. You can be very annoying. You've got the cripple, you got the knockup, you got a slow, you have the ult for CC. You've got a lot. Make sure you have your energy built up when you go into fights. You want to be able to use that max energy ult when you go into a fight. And as long as you can do that, you will literally be golden. I think that is a big thing that people don't realize. Building up that energy is very, very important and one of the keys to his kit. The other thing is the god wants to play very spammy. You're all about just using your abilities over and over and over in a fight. That doesn't mean you can't be killed. You can be killed in those abilities very easy. So be wary of who you're using the abilities on, where you're using them, and how you're using them. Your 3 can really get you caught up and killed, and then just being out of position going into early, especially with a squishy build like we talked about. So hope this quick god guide helps you guys out a little bit. I know a lot of you will want it for just the builds, but the rest of it will help you kind of understand what's going on. We're going to knock this out on every single god. It's going to be hard. It's not going to be easy. Subscribe, like, comment. Let's go. What's up, boys and girls of YouTube? Next up on our list of A to Z god guides, Achilles. We're going in order and we're knocking it out. We're playing Jungle Achilles, assuming. Obviously, if you play in the solo, builds are going to change up. You're going to be a lot tankier. This is a very hybrid type build. The build I'm going in the jungle. It is the optimal build for you 100%. You got Assassin's Blessing to start in the jungle. You have Mace 1 to start in the jungle. Blink if they don't have a lot of CC. Beads if they do. You're going Warrior Tabby for a lot of damage. You're going Crusher because your attack speed is really slow, but you actually hit very, very hard. Plus, the passive is insane when you have three damaging abilities. You're one, and then you're three twice. You've got Void Shield, so you've got a little bit of frontline, more pen, some health, and some more power. You've got the Onsile because you are diving in, and you want a little bit of CDR. Having the CDR is key. If you don't want to go into Onsile, they have a lot of physical damage and not a lot of magical, or you just don't want to go hybrid, swap out the Onsile and grab yourself a Jotun's. It's actually amazing. The CDR is sick. Or grab yourself a Hydra's if you're auto-attacking a lot. Either or. Next up, Magi's Cloak. You can get locked down very easily on Achilles, especially since you want to dive. Grab it, you won't get locked down. Titan's Bane, round out your pen, round out your damage. Ability-wise, you want to max out your 1, you want to max out your 3, you want to max out your ult, and you want to max out your 2. Your 1 is going to be your biggest burst damage. Your 3 is going to be your overall higher damaging ability, though, because the ability 3 can hit twice, plus you're able to auto-attack in between them. The 1's only going to hit once, and it's on a long cooldown. Obviously, you're going to level the 1 because the 1 is guaranteed. The 3 is awesome, but it's not guaranteed. In every fight, you're not going to get your 3 off twice. But if you are, if you see the game playing out like that where you're just doing whatever the hell you want, level the 3, you'll be great. I like leveling the 1 because it's just consistent over all levels. So there's your build. There's your abilities. Now we're going to go into matchups. Achilles is great at chasing gods that don't have super high mobility. So if you're looking at other assassins, it's honestly great at chasing gods like Rat. It's great at chasing gods like Nemesis. It's great at chasing gods like Najah. Anything that just has no regular mobility and no leaps, you're going to do just fine chasing. I really do like Achilles into those gods. Plus, you have the ultimate to break any CCs. So say a Humbats is ulting you, you can actually ult just to go ahead and not be CC'd and get extra damage off. Those are your okay jungle matchups. Mage-wise, once again, lower mobility, easier to kill. You can lock down Isis, you can lock down Zeus, you can lock down Ra. I like it into Raijin a lot. I love it into Raijin. Even though Raijin can dash over walls, once you get the dash out, you can chase with a blink or your ultimate. Once you catch back up to Raijin, he's dead. You just do so well at killing Raijin. It's amazing. Apwash, you frag. Gods you'll get destroyed on as mages. Scylla, Agni. Just things that can get away from you and do a lot of damage in return. Thoth can fuck you up. I actually like playing in a Vulcan too. You can juke the meatballs very, very easily when you are playing against him. So I like that. Playstyle for Achilles. Early game, you want to be up in their face. You have a lot of control. You have the ability to juke abilities with your 3. And then you have a decent amount of poke. You just have good, consistent damage because you've got 3 abilities that are doing damage plus the auto attacks in between. Your auto attacks hit very, very hard. So early game, you're looking to poke. Don't overextend yourself. Mid game is where you can pretty much one tap people or just do a lot of their health with the build I gave you, even though it is somewhat hybrid. Very, very late game, you aren't super tanky. You're a hybrid build. You don't want to be going in face tanking. You don't want to be jumping in first. Let some abilities go out. Blink on top of the squishy. If the squishy uses their mobility, definitely blink on top of them. You can play that way. Or if that's just not working out for you, you can play in the back line. You have the CC to lock someone down for your team. So say the other team has, I don't know, a Baka diving or a Hunbats diving. You're able to get a stun off and control that jungler that's diving or that person that's up in their face and help out. And then you can execute with your ultimate and just turn. You can, same with frontline. If, say, a tank, a Wukong or something that doesn't have an ultimate, just any Osiris. We'll go Osiris. We'll go Bologna. We'll go Chalk. Any of them. Hercules. They're diving in the backline. You're able to actually, with the execute, knock somebody out super fast. So just tell your mages and your hunter, hey, kill this guy, get him the fucking the lower percentage, ultimate, dead, boom, perfect. Achilles in a nutshell. You have lots of ways to play the game, lots of ways to play the god. As I said with the build, the hybrid build is what I recommend. You can swap all this up and go full damage. That can become a Jotun's, that can become a Brawler's, that can become a Void Shield, Masamune, that can become Titan's Bane if you want to go a full damage route. Just want to throw that in there. There's your 5 minutes or under Achilles guide. Subscribe, like, comment. Let's go. What up, boys and girls and YouTube? Of YouTube, back with another God Guide in under 5 flipping minutes. We're knocking out Agni, boys and girls. We're knocking out Agni in the mid-roll. To be realistic, because you're not jungling Agni. I know you might want to, but you're not doing it. So to start off with, I like going Talon Trinket, which is rank 2 of Bancross. It's 1,400 gold. It allows you to have a lot of power. You're pulling out 60 power, the extra mana, the little bit of lifesteal. The 60 power is going to increase your clear speed drastically. Plus, I like the little bit of sustain you end up getting out of this once you finish Bancross. It's a pretty big early power spike on Agni, which I kind of believe is necessary. I start with 1 health, 1 mana. Play really smart. You're just trying to farm up and get the 1,100 gold for Bancross Talon. That's your main goal, is just farm for the first few minutes. Get to level 5 as fast as possible. You're going to finish Bancroft, go into Shoes of the Magi, go into Spear of the Magus. That is going to, this amount of damage you will pump out with these three items will be insane. You will destroy everybody in the mid 3v3 with these three items as soon as you finish them. Then I go Soul Reaver for the extra poke, and then Chronos Pendant because I like a little bit of CDR while keeping a decent amount of power, and then rounding it out with a Rata Tahuti. That is by far my favorite build. You will destroy kids with it. Have fun. I like to start with my 3, dash back through the creeps, just kill all the creeps with your 3, easy peasy, auto attack, boom, that's off the start. I max my 2 first, ultimate, 3, 1. Boom, 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 boom. There you go, there's the abilities. Matchups wise, you're actually one of the best matchups in Hera, honestly. Hera has an amazing game right now. And Agni has a very strong matchup in the Hera because you're able to poke from range while just never getting in Hera's face. And it's really, really nice. You're also able to avoid the sheeps very easily because when she's casting your sheep, you can cast your bomb stun and just kind of play around it. It's awesome. You hard counter Isis because you can stop the clear once you're level 5. You do very well against everything that is super immobile. Ra, you'll do well against if you build a Divine instead of the Spear of the Magus. Great. Awesome. Just anything without mobility that you can poke. Janus, you can poke out really well. You just have a lot of options with that ranged fucking damage coming out on Agni. You also, out of the jungle, you hard counter Sirkette. Beads, bomb yourself. Sirkette dies. You pretty much hard counter anything that can't chase you very well. And be smart with your dashes and you'll just do fine. Even if you don't hard counter them or you don't have a great matchup against somebody, you'll usually be just fine and neutral as long as you're not dashing out of position or standing really far out of position. The playstyle on Agni is very simple. Poke around over walls, throw your bombs over the wall, does great. You have bomb stun, you have control. That's the early to mid game. Over the wall, over the wall, over the wall, or corner, corner, corner. Just play off of everything. CC, control, damage. You don't have to get kills. You don't have to full dive in. Look for the damage. If it's there, kill them. If it's not, just hit the 3 bombs, get the awesome poke, go take a camp. Easy. Late game, make sure you're behind your team. Make sure you're not wasting your dash because you can be dove very easily. You die so fast once your dash is down. Don't waste your dash. Play back, look for that wall play. If the wall play isn't there, look for your team to be pushing into them where you're able to move up. Once you're able to move up, throw the bombs into the front line if you have to. If they're diving into you, like I said, play back, loop around a wall, throw bombs over the wall into the squishies, or just control the front line if that is what you have to do. And that is essentially Agni in a nutshell. That is by far my favorite god to play as just a neutral, like safe god most of the time. He does have some bad matchups. He does have some things that can go wrong. His clear isn't the best early game. So watch out for that. It's okay to not be punishing kids and fighting right off the back on Agni. Agni, you're playing for that level 5. Level 5 is the dream. Level 5 is the goal. Once you get it, you're good to go. Agni is pretty simple. Agni is really, really simple, honestly. Just remember, poke a lot. Control a lot with your stuns. Don't waste your dashes. You don't have to get in range to 2 if you don't feel safe. As long as you're doing that, you're going to punish some kids. If you see a Sirkette, pick Agni in a heartbeat. Hopefully this is helping you guys. Subscribe, like, comment. Thank you.